Yeah, hey there, Spence. I'm over here working on Cabinet Vision, and I was wondering, do you guys have another catalog for Bosch appliances?
Does Cabinet Vision carry the Viking catalog?
Hey, did you ask him about Frigidaire yet? I bet they don't have Frigidaire.
What about Thermidor? I bet they don't have Thermidor.
The answer is yes. This is probably the most asked question that I get. From day to day, people are wondering because they're designing for this guy or that lady, and they wanted to see their exact range or their exact vent hood in their drawing. That doesn't mean they want you to actually be able to build it, but they want to be able to see what it looks like next to all the stuff that you built. Well, I will show you how to import a 3D model for most things right now. So obviously there are a few little tips and tricks to know in order to be able to do this and do this right and do this well. But ultimately, for the full know-how of all of this, it's probably best to go through Cabinetvision and do an actual training session with one of their applications engineers. So, just so that you can see this completely from scratch and so that you know that you have access to this completely free. This is something offered by Google that you could use anytime you wanted to. Cabinetvision's 3D object warehouse is relatively generic. Now, it's kept generic on purpose because there are so many different makes and so many different models from so many different manufacturers that it becomes really, really hard to keep track of catalogs of those exact products. Instead, what they offer is a variety of different refrigerators with a variety of different arrangements. Maybe it's a double door, maybe the freezer is down at the bottom, maybe it has two drawer options. Who knows? Either way, there should be some kind of option in there that's actually a scalable object that Cabinetvision can use. But if that's not good enough for you, you can go directly to the 3D warehouse and find what you're looking for. So I've drawn up a very simple job here. Now this has just a few little base cabinets, a few upper cabinets, and I'm gonna go to the appliances section right here and I am going to look for some kind of range. Let's go with a gas range, and you can see down there at the bottom what my options look like. I'm gonna go ahead and drop that in for the bottom. It's a nice little shape, it's scalable. That'll work for this, but my customer wanted to see what it looked like with a bell curved hood. So I'm gonna go ahead and go find that hood. So first things first, let's go find it. We're gonna click out of here and we're gonna go to whatever your browser is. And then we're just gonna go to the Google 3D warehouse. You can set up a Google account. You can download this. It's completely free. Or you can go to 3dwarehouse.sketchup.com. As soon as you do that, you get access to all of these different 3D models. I am gonna go ahead and let's do vent hoods. Perfect. So the two things that I'm looking for specifically on these is I wanna make sure obviously that the textures look good and that the finish is decent. But the second thing I want to make sure is that these poly lines are not too much. You'll notice something like this that says vent hood. You might like the way it looks, but overall, that is 453,000 poly lines. Way too many poly lines. So I'm going to pick one that's a little simpler because I'm going to be able to apply textures to it directly, either in Cabinetvision, or I may be able to take this file directly from here and send it to Vortek Spaces to get really, really good textures. And if you stick around, I may be able to show you at the end a cloud-based solution that gives you access to every single one of these items that you might be looking for, plus the ability to use your own Cabinetvision files in order to create the design without having to go to Google SketchUp or do any of that work around. So stay tuned for the end. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe.
So when you get to this section, it asks for either a collada file or a SketchUp file. I always go with a SketchUp file because it just seems like the right thing to do. I couldn't tell you why I do it.
So we've got our Cabinet Vision file back open. We've got a range here, but we want to put our little hood in this spot. So we'll go to Utilities up here at the top, Import SketchUp Model, and there's our component. We'll put that in. You'll notice over here, you've got these little directions. This is how you know which direction you want it to face. See, it doesn't know that just yet. So you'll have to arrange exactly how you want it to be viewed. In this case, with this being the zero point, it shoots out this way and goes up and down. I think this was what I was hoping for, but I also need to flip it this way. So I'll go ahead and hit save. It'll say I need to allocate a part type. For me, I think I'll be okay just labeling it as some random assembly because I'm not using it for anything else, really. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'll call it just a filler. We'll hit okay. We'll hit save here. Then since this is an appliance, we'll go over here and go to hoods. I wanna put it in traditional hoods and I'm gonna call it test hood 2, since I already had a test hood 1. You'll notice that there isn't an icon for the range hood over here. You're gonna look and look and look. It's actually right here under the advanced section. So you'll go to appliance, you'll go to hood, and that is how you will have that icon. Then you'll want to set the placement. So I want it on the wall. I want to be able to stretch my height, my width, my depth, and I want it to be placed above the elevation, 60 inches above the elevation. I'm going to hit okay. Then I'll hit okay. Should be able to exit out now, go to my objects, my appliances. I should be able to go to range hoods and have test hood 2. As soon as I do that, I'll drop her in here. It didn't stick to 60, but that's easy enough. I can go right here. And in fact, I think it may actually be closer to, let's call it 48. And you go to your 3D models, and you've got yourself a nice 3D model that you can use. Once you've got everything exactly how you want it to, you can take it to XRender, assign textures to everything, and set it up to look almost photorealistic. If you were looking for an even faster solution, you can then take your Cabinet Vision file to Vortek Spaces. I'll show you how to do that now. Within Cabinet Vision, you can go to your 3D view and then go to XRender, Utilities, and then you'll have the option to take your file and save it as a Vortek file. You put it in your downloads or wherever you want to store it. And I'll put mine as a sample test. This will be a bad test because it doesn't have a ceiling, but it does have a floor. Once the application opens, I can go directly to one of these sections where I can select a file to import, or I can open one of my existing projects. I'll open my test file. Once the package downloads all of the necessary items, once inside Vortek, I can simply select a surface and automatically be met with a number of different options from a number of different vendors. I can select here and have access to Egger, Sublime, Shinoki, Finsa, Wilson Art, all kinds of great options. I can select any and in real time be able to change all of that. These were achieved granted options within Cabinet Vision. And they were able to draw it up and be able to provide all of the necessary skeleton to design and render this design. Black, you can also create walkthroughs and visits that you can then upload to YouTube.
New colors.
It's a great product. Now, I've always said I take pride in how terrible my renderings are. But that's a pretty horrible render. So let me show you around some of the renders that aren't terrible. This technically isn't even a sponsored product for Cabinet Vision. I just really think it's a game changer if you are looking to get high-end renderings to your customers quickly.
If you want to see all of that done within Cabinet Vision's XRender, I can do that too. It just takes just a little bit longer, and you have to know and be able to finesse it just a little bit better. So I like being able to import 3D models and then add my textures after the fact. But there are a lot of people who are very good at doing it in both of those ways. Your choice.
So with that said, hopefully this was helpful and you got a little bit out of it. And if you didn't, keep on scrolling. There's probably something out there for you. With Cabinetvision Made Simple, my name is Spencer Baker. Have a wonderful day.